In our previous Microsoft Word tutorial videos, we had learned that how you can insert a new table, or draw a table, and even how you can convert simple text into table. In this video, you will learn that how you can quickly design and format your table, and spice the table up. Sometimes, when getting late for an office meeting, you may require to quickly format and design your table, so you may present it on the desk. This is when the Design tab under Table Tools comes to handy. By default, when you insert a new table in a Word document, the default table style is Table Grid, with a dark black lines for your entire table. But Word gives you many more predefined table styles to choose from. Place your cursor inside the table, and if you hover your mouse over these table styles, you can instantly see a live preview in your document. If you click the drop-down button, then you can see a vast list of ready-made table styles. You can pick any table style that you want. Let's say, for this example I choose, Grid Table 4, Accent 5. As you can see that, in a blink of eye, your entire table has been redesigned automatically. But you may want to customize this table a bit, according to your preferences. As you can see, there are a few more options under Table Style options. For this table style, header row, banded rows and first column options are pre-checked. Let's see what these options does. If your current table contains a header row, like I have in this table, crumbs and prices per bag, then you might want a different color and style for your header row, and this is what exactly the header row under Table Styles option does. It fills an extra dark color in your header row, so it may look slightly a bit different from other rows. If your table does not contain any headings, then you may uncheck this option. If the last row of your table contain a total sum of values, then you may like to give it a separate formatting. So as I check the total row option, you can see that the last row has been separated by applying a double border. Then we have banded rows option. As you can see in the following table that, each second row has a slightly darker color than others, and this is what the banded row options does. If you uncheck this option, all the rows will have the same formatting. I like the banded rows, so I will remain it checked. This also goes with the banded columns option. If your table consists of more than two columns, then you can experiment with banded columns as well, which automatically fills the color in every second column of your table. As the first column option is checked by default, and what it does is, it makes the contents in the first column darker by automatically applying the bold command, and the same does the last column option, which also applies bold command to the contents of your last column. So, this is how you can customize the table after using a predefined table style. And it is up to you that how you want to format your table. If you want to experiment with the filled color, then you have the shading option in Design tab. It lets you customize fill color in rows and columns according to your preference. Like, if I click the drop-down button and choose a lighter blue color, then it will instantly apply to the current selected cells. Do note that, the shading applies to the selected area only. So you must first select those contents to whom you want to apply the shading, and that could be a single row or a single column. Or you can apply shading to the entire table by selecting it from the four side arrow button. But if you fill the entire table with a single color, then table style options will no longer be effective, as you will lose banded row, first column, total row, other styles. If you want to customize the borders of your table, then you can do this by clicking the border style drop-down button. The default selected border style is solid line style, but you can go for other styles, like for a more depth line or a double line border. As I select a double line border style, you can see that the border painter button has automatically been selected, and now when I move the mouse pointer inside the document, you can see that it has changed to pencil style. Now, draw the lines over the borders that you want to change. You can have different border styles for different lines. You can even customize the border color by clicking on Paint Color. You can also customize the line style and line width before applying the border, and then nicely draw it over the current borders. You can also add or remove borders from the borders button. Like, if I want to remove the borders from entire table, then first I select the entire table, and then click No Borders from the Borders drop-down menu. You can even apply border to a specific selected area. We will cover border customization options in much detail in our next lesson. Hope you will find this video useful. Leave us your suggestions and comments in the box below. Don't forget to hit the like button, and do share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching, and take care.